हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू योर चैनल मेक फिजिक्स इजीयर। माय मयूर अग्रवाल, टुडे योर फ्रेंड योर टीचर मयूर इज विद यू विद अ न्यू टॉपिक एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड अ टॉपिक वेयर एवरी स्टूडेंट फील्स लिटिल अनकंफर्टेबल एंड दैट टॉपिक इज वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस। There is a basic problem in word problem is that the language. To understand the language, we have to do practice as much as question we can. Then only we have a super confidence that yes, we can do the word problem. There is no such criteria that word problems are very hard always. Mostly word problems are very easy. But the problem is students demotivate themselves earlier before starting the questions. Okay, so this is a very wrong habit, a very bad habit. So you have to be very careful, very confident before starting the word problems. And word problems are related to any chapter will obviously humiliate you. Like they will produce some humiliation in you. But this is not the problem. The problem is mainly relies on the understanding language. If you will understand the language of the word problem, then definitely you can do. So, for that purpose, I had made this video. So, watch the video till end. And if you have any suggestions, then you can ask. So, let's start today's video. So, on the basis of word problems, I have divided some categories. So, type 1. Type 1 I have taken generally numbered questions. Only related to numbers and simple conditions. So, I am writing down question number 1 over here. Question 1 is, find 2 consecutive even natural numbers such that sum of their squares is 340. So, this is the first question which is very easy. Find two consecutive even. Consecutive also and even also. So, when a condition like this, if I am asking that give me the example of two consecutive even numbers, then you can give me 2 and 4, 6 and 8. So basically we are looking at the first thing is even numbers and then consecutive. So even consecutive means there is a difference of 2. Then only we can say that the given numbers are consecutive also and even also. So we have to consider, let numbers are x and x plus 2. So these are the two numbers, because there are two numbers, so x and x plus 2. Now the condition is, according to condition, sum of their squares. So first of all you will do the square of separate the terms, then add them, because sum of their squares is equal to 340. So now this is a quadratic equation. First we convert them into a general form. X square plus x square plus 4 plus 4x is equal to 340. Now x square will become 2x square plus 4x plus 4 minus 340 is equal to 0. 2x square plus 4x minus 336 is equal to 0. You can take 2 common. X square plus 2x minus 1, 6, 8 is equal to 0. So x square plus 2x minus 168 is equal to 0. 2 will place over here. So 0 divided by 2, the answer will be 0. Now we can solve this quadratic equation with the help of factorization. Middle term is meaning we have to search about two numbers where multiplication is minus 168 and their subtraction is 2. So factorize 168. 2 8 is 16, 2 4 is 8, 2 42, 2 21 and 3, 7. So 3 to the 6, 6 to the 12. And 7 to the 14. 14 and 12. So x square
plus 14x minus 12x minus 168 is equal to 0. And I am telling you definitely, if you are not able to find the factors, then you can use the Sridharacharya formula. Formula method you can also do. Okay? And formula method I have explained in you the previous video. आप मेरे प्रीवियस वीडियोस को सर्च करके वहां से श्रीधराचार्य फॉर्मूला मेथड कैसे सॉल्व करते हैं वहां से आप सर्च कर सकते हैं. सो वी टेक x कॉमन x प्लस 14 माइनस 12 कॉमन अगेन x प्लस 14 इज इक्वल टू 0. सो इन द फर्स्ट ब्रैकेट x प्लस 14, इन द सेकेंड ब्रैकेट x माइनस 12. सो इफ वी आर टेकिंग x माइनस 12 इज इक्वल टू 0, देन द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज 12. And if we are taking x plus 14 is equal to 0, then the value of x will be minus 14. And we have to find two consecutive even natural numbers. This word, natural, we know very well that negative numbers are not natural numbers. So we cannot take this answer. We'll accept x is equal to 12. So the first number will be 12 and the second number will be 12 plus 2, which is 14. So this is the type 1 questions. There is no such problem which the students are facing. The main problem is about their practice. If they will practice each type of question separately, then they definitely they will get the confidence level. And when they will, once they will get the confidence, then nothing can be done with the help of these questions. Every question you can solve it very easily. So we are going to discuss type 2 questions now. In the first type of questions, we have just values, conditions and placing. Now I am going to make a little change in the language. Now the questions language will definitely confuse you. I have considered a question type 2. These are the fractional questions about fractions. In a positive fraction, the denominator is greater. Denominator is greater than numerator, by 3 if one is subtracted from both fraction decreased by 1 on 14. We have to find the fraction. So this is the question about fractions. So here in a positive fraction, denominator is greater than numerator by 3. Till this full stop, we can let the denominator and numerator separately. Denominator is greater than numerator by 3. So let numerator be x. On the basis of numerator is x and denominator is greater than numerator by 3. So denominator will become x plus 3. Is that clear? If you have considered numerator as x, then denominator is x plus 3 according to this condition. Now, fraction will become, what will be the fraction now? So fraction is equal to x upon x plus 3. This is the original fraction. According to condition, 1 is subtracted from both. So, new fraction. According to question we are working, x minus 1 upon x plus 3 minus 1. So, it will become x minus 1 upon x plus 2. This is the new fraction. After subtracting 1 from both numerator and denominator, it is said as 1 by 14. The fraction decreased by 1 by 14. So the original fraction was x upon x plus 3. New fraction is x minus 1 upon x plus 2. Their decrease by 1 upon 14. So their difference is equal to 1 by 14. Now you can solve this. You will definitely get the answer. Now you can take LCM. x plus 3, x plus 2. Here it will become x and x plus 2 minus x minus 1 and x plus 3 is equal to 1 by 14. So here it will become x square plus 2x minus. Always take a bracket so that your sign mistakes will not be done. So x into x, x square minus plus 3x minus x and minus 3 upon x plus 3 and x plus 2. That will go cross multiply. So x plus 3 over here and x plus 2 over here and 14 multiplied with all these numbers. Okay, so solve it. 14 x square plus 2x minus x square minus 3x plus x and plus 3 is equal to, here multiply both terms, x square plus 3x plus 2x and plus 6. These terms are there. So I am going to erase these two steps so that I can solve the given equation over here. So here we can say that x square and x square will be cancelled. 2x plus x, it will become 3x and minus 3x. These terms will be cancelled. Remaining 3. 3 multiplied by 14. 14 3 are 42 is equal to, here it is x square plus 3 and 2, 5x plus 6. So 0 is equal to x square plus 5x plus 6 minus 42. So 0 is equal to x square plus 5x minus 36. Now this is a perfect quadratic equation. We have to think about two numbers whose multiplication is 36 and subtraction is 5. So you can take 9 and 4, x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 36. I am going to again erase these two steps more for solving the equation. Now you can take common, x plus 9 minus 4 common, x plus 9. So there are two fractions. The first fraction is x plus 9 and the second fraction is x minus 4. Now if you are going to take x plus 9 is equal to 0, then the value of x is minus 9. And if you will take x minus 4 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 4. We can accept only this answer because it is written at in a positive fraction. So it is written in the question, that is why we cannot take the negative value. We cannot accept minus 9. We can accept only 4. So according to the question, numerator is 4. Denominator is 4 plus 3, 7. So the fraction will be 4 upon 7. So this is the complete answer. So these are the type 2 questions. As we have earlier discussed that we have to be just concentrate on the language of the question. We have not to be very fast while we are reading the question. If we have read the questions properly, then definitely we can consider the terms. The first statement of any quadratic equation will help you out to consider the terms. And the second statement will help you out to find the equation, to make the equation, to frame the equation. So your listening abilities and your reading ability will make you perfect in these type of questions. So these are the basically type 2 questions regarding fractions. Now one more question which every student has faced some problems, and that question is of numbers, related to numbers. There is a type of question in which numbers are, the digits are interchanged. The third type of question I am going to discuss is, there is a convergence, there is a connection between the unit digit and tens digit, and they are reversed. Means unit digit becomes tens digit and tens digit becomes unit digit. Then there is a difference between the numbers. So according to that condition. So let's start a question on this condition. Yes, these are the type 3 questions. Now a two digit positive number is such that a two-digit positive number is such that product of its digits is 6. Full stop. If 9 is added, if 9 is added to the number, the digits interchange their places. The digits interchange their places. Find the number. We have to find the original number. So look, how can we solve this? Two digit positive number means there are two digits. One must be unit digit and second must be tens digit. So we have considered. Let unit digit be x and so tens digit will be, according to question, the product of digit is 6. The product of digit is 6. So if we are considering first number is 3, then the second number will become 6 divided by 3. If we are considering first number as 2, then the second number will become 6 divided by 2. So here we are considering the unit digit being x. So the tens digit will become 6 by x. So according to this condition, original number. According to this condition only, original number. Number is always written by 10 multiplied by tens digit. 6 upon x plus 1 multiplied by unit digit means x. So it will become 60 upon x plus x. This is the original number. Now, new number which is forming by the interchanging digits. 10 into x. Now the x will become tens digit. And 6 upon x will become unit digit. So the number will be 10x plus 6 upon x. And it is conditioned. If 9 is added to the number, means original number is added with 9. So 60 upon x plus 9 is equal to interchange number, new number. 10x plus 6 upon x. Now we have to solve this only. So we can say as 9 is equal to 10x minus x plus 6 upon x minus 60 upon x. Now let's solve this equation. So 9 is equal to, it will become 9x plus, it will become minus 54 by x. We can take 9 as common. So 1 is equal to x minus 9, 6, 6 by x. Cross multiply, first LCM, x square minus 6 upon x. So from here we can write it as x is equal to x square minus 6. So x square minus x minus 6 is equal to 0. We have to think about two numbers where multiplication is 6 and their subtraction is 1. So 3 and 2, x square minus 3x plus 2x minus 6 is equal to 0. So x common, x minus 3, 2 common, x minus 3. So we can easily say that there are two factors. The first factor is x minus 3 and second factor is x plus 2. When we take x minus 3 as a factor, then the value of x is 3. And if we take plus 2, then the answer is minus 2. Because the numbers are positive, so we cannot accept minus 2. We can accept the number as 3. We can accept the digit. Unit digit will become 3. Unit digit is x, so the value of x is 3. So unit digit is 3 and tens digit is 6 divided by 3, which will become 2. So the number will be 23. Because unit digit has come 3 and the tens digit is 6 divided by 3, which is 2. So the number is 23. So by this method we can solve such questions in which interchanging is there. Digits are interchanged, so we have to frame original number first. And always remember that when you are going to frame a number, then 10 is multiplied with the tens digit and 1 is multiplied with the ones digit. This concept you are using since class 6. Okay, so this is the methodology for solving the questions related to interchanging numbers. So these are the type 3 questions. Now, I am going to discuss with you a new type of question, different type of questions, type 4. We have to search about the questions which we can understand and which we can take help from the topic. The next question is about area and perimeters, means you can say mensuration mixed with the quadratic equation. So, these are the type 4 questions. A rectangle of area 105 centimeter square has length x centimeter. Write down its breadth in terms of x. Perimeter is given 44. Perimeter is 44. So we have to find the dimensions of the rectangle. Okay, so according to the question, length is x, area is equal to length into breadth. Area is given 105, length is x, so the breadth will become, we can solve this, 105 divided by x. This is the value of breadth in terms of x. Now perimeter is given 44. Formula for perimeter is 2, length plus breadth. So 2 will be divided, so length plus breadth is equal to 22. Now length is x and breadth is 105 divided by x. So this is the equation. Take LCM, x square plus 105 upon x is equal to 22. We have to solve this equation. So x square plus 105 is equal to 22x. So x square minus 22x plus 105 is equal to 0. Now we have to think about two numbers where multiplication is 105, addition is 22. So 15 and 7, x square minus 15x minus 7x plus 105 is equal to 0. Solve this, x minus 15 minus 7, x minus 15 is equal to 0. So in the first bracket, x minus 15, in the second bracket, x minus 7. So the first value of x is 15 and 7. When you are going to take L, length 15, then the breadth will be 105 upon 15, which will become 7. Length 15, breadth 7. And if length is 7, then the breadth is 15. So both answers can be possible. Both answers are possible because we have not any condition that length is always greater than the breadth. Such condition is not given in the question. So there must be two answers. If length is 15, breadth will be 7. If length is 7, then the breadth will be 15. So this is the questions related to mensuration on the basis of area and perimeter. So this is the today's video. I have discussed four type of quadratic problems, word problems with you. In the next video, I will discuss some more interesting problems which you face, which wherever you have problem. But if you have such problems or any suggestion, then you can give me personally. Okay, so thank you for watching my video and do subscribe my channel, like as much as you can.